all. All right. Well, YouTube's been down for about a week here in the San Francisco Bay Area and many places around the planet, from what I'm reading online, is that they had a major meltdown and you couldn't get it to play or upload or anything. So apparently they're back up and YouTube is now running at least normal here in the Bay Area. So I'll upload a new environmental video. So my therapy from when I fell is going okay. It's not as fast as I'd like it. It's about 2 to 3 times a week and it takes a lot of time. And so it's hard to find the extra time to do videos, but I will try it whenever possible. We'll just have to live with that until my therapy starts to lessen. It could take as long as a year of physical therapy, they say, to regain all my motion and my ability to where I was before the fall. All right, today we're going to talk about the consequences of climate change and what is happening, what the updates are, what new news is out. And there is some new news. The climate crisis is better called climate violence, which is producing record storms, wildfires, droughts, sea level rise, floods, and unprecedented heat waves around the planet. Millions of lives are already being lost, with even more people suffering from climate-related illnesses and injuries. More rampant destruction of agriculture, soil erosion, habitat destruction, and the regional spread of insect-borne diseases such as malaria. And over in Greenland, the Greenland ice is losing 33 million tons of ice per hour due to the climate crisis. Just remember, it wasn't too long before there wasn't hardly anything happening with Greenland. This just started and now it's really cranking up. A new study finds that the Greenland ice sheet is retreating 20% more than previously thought. Greenland glaciers are melting fast. There is a chance that crucial ocean current systems could soon collapse. Now that's been controversial, whether that's going to happen or not, but there's more and more evidence showing that that is happening and that the slowdown of the currents around the ocean, as more and more fresh water is added to the ocean, it slows down the currents. Over the 38-year period, Greenland lost about 1,930 square miles of ice, equivalent to 1 trillion metric tons and roughly the size of the U.S. state of Delaware. Almost every glacier in Greenland is retreating. A glaciologist at NASA said this retreat is happening everywhere and all at once. So there's a project called the Environmental Voter Project. They are urging U.S.ans to consider the environment when you choose the candidate and the political party they will support in 2024. So they're asking people to really pay attention to the politics that's going on today. I know a lot of people can't stand politics and wish to just wipe their hands of it because there isn't any clear way to vote. It's both parties and they suck, and we know they suck. So just make sure you do a lot of research before you vote and just throw in the towel and say, oh, I'll vote for A because I like the way he sounds. You have to look at their environmental record and what they've done, who's done what, and all that. But that's what they're asking people to do. Personally, I don't know. It's just so hard to put an X next to anybody's name who's running. They all suck. And there's obviously a clear winner when it goes to the environment, but it's not much of a win, really. The wins are small and far few between, but there's a clear winner between one side and the other. So we're going to keep this one short. I have an hour to get ready and head on over and have my shoulders checked on to see how well they're doing with the physical therapy. We're still not sure whether we need a surgery on my right shoulder or not. It's in bad shape and the progress is slow. On the left side, obviously we don't need surgery on the left shoulder, but the right shoulder we may end up having to get surgery, which would mean 6 to 8 months of physical therapy on top of the surgery. So hopefully we can avoid the surgery at all costs. We're sure going to try. And we're giving it all we can for our physical therapy, both at home and at the clinic. So I appreciate you guys watching the video and being concerned of the environment. Any ups, any new subscribers, and definitely your comments would all help the algorithm for YouTube to spread this video around. And until next time.